So these are some of the remedies. I have the big list of the other remedies which I have not mentioned here. So as I am being invited by one of the biggest disciple of Lord Krishna, so I have to talk about Lord Krishna here. And I have to talk about the tree which is associated, one of the trees, or the famous or the biggest or the associated with the Lord Krishna is the Pushya, which is also known as the people, Ashwatha, the Bodhi tree of enlightenment. And it is also known as Pushti'i, to strengthen, to fortify. And the Shakti behind that is, we all know, that the Pushya Nakshatra is Dhamma Varchasa Shakti, the power to create the spiritual energy. The star of nourishment, and when we say Babaji Ji, the star of nourishment, it is not only the nourishment of the stomach, it is the spiritual nourishment as well, which is all about Pushya. Because look at the energy behind this, the power to create the spiritual energy. So the body parts, lungs, it makes sense because Pushya falls in the Cancer sign. Lungs has to be involved. Ribs, again, falls in the cosmic chart. In the Kalpursh chart, ribs are seen also from the fourth bhava. Common ailments, eczema, jaundice. Who is the deity associated with Pushya? It's Brihaspati. And we all know which body part is associated with the Brihaspati. It's liver.
Interesting.
So we can see how we can treat our jaundice or our Brihaspati with the Pushya energy.
Oh, okay, and Jupiter reaches the peak exaltation at 5.
Yes, yes.
Pushya, and that is why people is associated with Pushya also.
Yes.
Okay.
So Lord Krishna, Lord Buddha is thought to have attained enlightenment under this people tree. So that is why it is called the Bodhi tree of enlightenment. Skanda Puran says, and it also reference actually, the Lord Vishnu was born under this tree. Lord Krishna died under this tree. So it shows the connection, Lord Vishnu. Bhagavad Gita, it says, Lord Krishna says, Ashwatha Sarvekshanam, amongst the trees, I am the Ashwatha. So how we cannot take this tree when I am on the exotic astrology?
In fact, I was thinking only if this was there or not in this slide. If it was not there, I would have told.
No, I deliberately.
As I was showing you that one photo I sent you, if you remember.
Right.
That among the planets, I am Brihaspati. He also
yes,
said that. So it
yes.
is, the connection is there here, you know, planets and.
So see how holy people tree
and,
is.
And he also says, among the nakshatras, I am the moon.
Yes.
You know, somebody was arguing that. But moon is not a nakshatra. Why does Krishna say like that? Krishna has done some grammatical errors. But moon is the lord of the nakshatras.
Yeah.
So he says that I am not any one of these nakshatras. I am directly the moon. Yes. So basically, he's saying that I am the lord of the nakshatras.
Right.
Interesting. Very interesting. This is.
And Babaji Ji, in Skanda Puran, it is explained Vishnu resides in the roots of the people tree, Keshav, which is the another name of Krishna that very well you know, resides in the trunk, Narayana in the branches, Lord Hari in the leaves, and all the gods in the fruits. This tree is like the deity of the Vishnu. I am the Ashwatha. So look at the importance. Like I'm literally getting goosebumps. So yeah.
All the Vishnu names are there, you see. Yes. Keshav is Vishnu.
So imagine.
There, Narayan, Hari is there.
Yeah. So imagine if we are serving the people tree, or if we start doing it, and again, just like I have mentioned before, even if we do it on a manas level, look at the amount of result one can get. But who thinks like that, who talks like that, who initiates, that is the key. Do we really initiating? Initiation is the key to everything.
In fact, I think from the whole presentation, if the one thing you want is, I think this should be the most important thing.
Yes, yes, absolutely. Pushya, Brihaspati ji is getting exalted here. So again, star of the nourishment, not only the nourishment of your stomach, nourishment of your spirituality. So one who is seeking for the spiritual guidance, or who is seeking the nourishment of the spirituality, peepal tree is the key remedy to do that. Stated in the Puranas. Here, I have taken a lot of references. That's why it took me a longer time to come up with the slides. So in the Rig Veda, Babaji ji, it is considered God as God. And in Athar Veda, it is considered at home of all gods. While in Yajur Veda, it is stated that for every yajna, the peepal tree is the most important. And Brahma, this is again a mythology which is connected to the ruling planet of Pushya, Shani. There were two demons. Brahma Puran says there were two demons, one by the name of Ashwatha and one by the name of Pipla. So what Ashwatha do, he took the form of the people, and the Pipla took the form of the Brahman. The fake Brahman would advise people to touch the tree, and as soon as they did, the Ashwatha would kill him. So the later, they both were killed by Shani. And again, the Shani is the ruler of the Pushya.
Planetary ruler, yes.
Yes. Look at the connection. And there were hundreds of connections. I am just putting in the slide only one connection. So that I might, maybe in the future, I might do another session where we can talk about all this. That's a separate topic. So according to the Athar Veda, the people is considered bless the barren woman and children. So how many of us, how many queries do you get for the same issue, for the progeny?
Yes.
Or for the same thing? Here's the remedy. Biggest karmic remedy or sattvic remedy one can do. And again, the sources I have mentioned in all of my slides. So let's talk few of the characteristics of the Pushya, characteristics of the Pipla, the people tree, sorry, and the remedies which we can get from this divine tree. I am the Ashwatha. Caring, nurturing, zeal for protection. Shani is involved. So protection has to be there, because that is the ruling planet as per the Vimshottari Dasha. Nurturing influence, general kindness, cool, calm, peaceful, religious. We all know about the Pushya. Peepal tree is the chief oxygen provider among all the trees. Contains glucose, again the nourishment. When we go to the hospital, what do we get when we cannot eat? We get the glucose in the liquid form. Here we are getting directly from the Ashwatha. So the star of nourishment. How beautiful that is. Leaves and the buds have the cooling effect. So these are the, again, leaves used as the fodder for elephants and camels. So see, star of nourishment, all the nourishment qualities are there. Treat jaundice. It is also one of the ailment is related with the stomach. So the bark of the tree is effective in stomatitis. Dried fruit can cure asthma, which is again one of the ailments associated with Pipla, with this nakshatra, asthma, lungs. Juice of the bark used as the mouthwash, preventing again the diseases. So see how beautiful it is working. See the zeal of the protection. And again, these are just few pointers I have mentioned here. There is a huge list of all the remedies which we can get just from the Ashwatha. So should we?
That is why I think if you go 2-3 slides back, mouth was also mentioned, right?
Yes, yes, yes. You got a nice eye, yes. Mouth, right here. And it is there, the juice of the bark used as the mouthwash.
Yes, yes.
Oh, so if we are having trouble with the same ailment or the disease, this is perfect remedy in the Ayurveda we can follow. Again, you can speak with your Ayurvedic doctor nearby you and confirm with him. We are no medical expert. This is just the, my interpretation in my presentation I'm giving out. So should we move on to the next nakshatra, Babaji ji?
Yes.
Oh, this is my favorite.
Purva
Falguni. The fruit of the tree, the star of the fortune. Shakti behind is Prajana Shakti, the power to create, creative procreation. Body part, we all know, it is associated with the sexual organ.